from Romeo and Michelle's high school reunion. We have Vassar here to claim that she is an alumni and board of trustee member of our beloved institution. In her career, she's been able to seamlessly transition between television, film, web series producing, and much more. Her intelligence and desire for her hard work and success have led to a rich, critically acclaimed career. In her commencement address to the Vassar class of 2010, she said, "Over time, through your work, you will demonstrate who you are and what you bring to your field." She truly embodies this quote through her passion, dedication, creativity, and ability to maintain a body of work that is challenging and of which she can be proud. Now, please give a warm welcome for Lisa Kudrow.
I wanted to have a say. in, you know, a creative say on what that show would be and how it would work, and that I actually needed some credentials as a producer. I mean, there were, you know, there were plenty of actors who were on TV shows that got, you know, they're called vanity deals, where, you know, yes, you can have a production company and the studio will pay for it and whatever, and that's fine, and you can say that you're a producer. But I really wanted to earn the right to be in the writer's room and, you know, have a say. So I just, I thought that's what I should do. If those are my plans, I have to sort of pay those dues in a way. And Dan, I wanted to work with Dan because he was a writer. And he had written, produced, and starred in a movie, a really good movie called All Over the Guy. And I thought he did such a great job. And because he did that, he was asked to write a pilot every year, a pilot or two. And so I thought, well, he knows this process too. But both of our agents said, you don't need each other. But we thought we did, so.
So which do you enjoy more, or is this for different reasons, being an actress, you know, in front of the camera, or sort of producing and directing for the set?
Well, I really like, I love the acting part. I love that. And I really enjoy the writing, too. I like writing with someone else a lot, because when I write by myself, I feel like I like fall into a hole for 3 hours or 4 hours. And it's unsettling to me. But producing, I really love producing Who Do You Think You Are? That's a series we do. It's a genealogy series, documentary, sort of historical documentary series that someone really smart created in the UK. I love producing that one because I get to be involved in every stage if I want, and I do want to. We just had like a 5-hour research meeting where I get to find out before, you know, the celebrity that's being taken on their journey. You know, we had been asked a lot, like in 2007 or 6 even, hey, don't you want to do a web series? And the answer was no, I don't. Because it looked like they were just sort of sitcom pilots that didn't go anywhere, and they were chopped up into 5-minute sections and then, you know, broadcast on the internet. And so we didn't really have an interest in that. But whenever I say an emphatic no, my brain keeps working on it, because just like an absolute no is usually not right. So my brain just kept working on it without me knowing. And I just started thinking, you know, it should be something, if you do a web series, it shouldn't just be like a pile of chopped up, it should be something that has to do with the web. That would be fun, something that has to do with the web. People are doing a lot of things on the web. Maybe they shouldn't be doing, you know, they just sort of check things off their to-do list, and they really only have the attention span to like sit there and watch something for 3 minutes long, I was told. How funny would it be if people, like during work, took a 3-minute break and had therapy? That would be really stupid. That's the worst idea in the world, and I bet people would do it. The internet, because there are no rules and there are no regulations, and you know, Don Roos and Dan Bukatinski, they thought that was really funny. And it was almost like, you know, the three of us, like, isn't that a funny idea? That's really funny. So let's order lunch. That was the end of that.
You've had so many amazing guest stars. Do you have a favorite or a few favorites that you
may aside from Meryl Streep? Because that was a very big deal. It really was a big deal on every possible level. Not just because I think she's, you know, greatest actress who's ever lived. And I mean it. That's not a joke. It's not even hyperbole. I mean, I think she has no equal. But also because Meryl did it and was hilarious. Not a surprise. It was sort of after that, why couldn't someone else do it?
Yeah.
I mean, if it's good enough for Meryl Streep. But we left who we had gotten before Meryl. But the other person I had so much fun with was Conan O'Brien. I could not believe how much fun that was because I forgot, because I forget everything.
Yeah.
That, yes, he reminded me, he said, this is like 1987. We'd be like driving around to improv classes or out to dinner or something, and we'd just do these endless bits. It's like, oh, that's right, we did do this. It's like, that's so familiar. Oh my gosh, that was really fun.
So in the entertainment industry, it's often hard for actors to transition from like television to film, etc. But in terms of your career, you have transitioned between many different mediums. So was that intentional, or how do you think it influenced your career path?
It wasn't intentional. It was just opportunity that I grabbed. You know, I think I understood Romy and Michelle because I was playing, you know, a certain idiot on TV. So it made sense that I'd play another kind of idiot in a movie. And I had done that character in a play. So, you know, I've known that character for a long time. But to me, the big deal was Don Roos asking me to be an opposite of sex to play this character. It was an independent film, and it was a dark comedy, no jokes, really. And he asked me to play this character that was not a ditz or idiot, other than a normal person who, you know, can be an idiot at times, you know, and be unaware of himself. So that was, I asked him even at the meeting, why do you want me? I mean, I want to do it. I know I can do it because I know me, but you don't know me. So why, what recommended me to you? And he said, I saw Romy and Michelle. And I knew you could do it. Okay, all right. I mean, either he made it up, or he really thought so. But I don't care, thank you. And then, that's the funny thing. So from then on, I was doing a lot of independent films. In independent films, I never played anyone like Phoebe, or Michelle Weinberger. That's her name. I can't wait to be even older than I am now. And playing women, I just think it's so much more interesting when you get to play women and it's not about being cute or sexy or, you know, the object of desire. And it's just about, you know, the experience that they've collected and some wisdom to impart. All right, here's the other thing I want to say. Whatever job it is that you have to take, don't be too pissed off at it. You know, because what I remember is people being really angry, and I went through a period also where I was a receptionist in my father's office, and I went through this period where I felt just a little discouraged about, you know, my career, and I'm working in this, you know, answering phones, and I'm filing, and oh my God, and I know people who have to wait tables and do whatever it is that you have to do while you're figuring out, or, you know, waiting for opportunities to come. Just don't get really mad. The job doesn't identify you. You're not that. You're you, and this is what you're doing right now. So just try to like be patient, because that way at least you can do a good job at whatever it is that you're doing. And those are the things that people notice, honestly. You never know who's gonna walk into that office or that restaurant and, you know, think you're doing a great job and at least ask you a little something about yourself. You just never, ever, ever know when or where an opportunity is going to come up or where it's going to come from. So you just have to show up the best version of yourself every day if you can. That's my advice.